In this video, I'm going to show you how to bind a report to a database using Express Persistent Objects, or XPO for short. First, let's right-click on the project and add a new item. This item is a data item, and we're going to select the DExperience ORM data model wizard. Let's call it Northwind and hit Add. We're going to map to an existing database. Hit Next. And it's already set to the local server name. Let's select the Northwind database again. Next, let's select the categories table and hit Next. Remove Generate Comments, hit Next, and finally, hit Finish. Notice that it automatically created an object for our categories table. We'll go ahead and build, and note that it created a categories object. The designer object has all the fields available, and you can extend the class any way you want using the partial class. XPO also created a connection helper in order to set the default connection settings. Okay, great. Let's add a report. To do that, right-click and add a new item. This item is going to be a report class. We'll call it Category Report. Let's bind to the objects we've created. We'll go to the data source and we'll add a project data source. Select Object and click Next. Drill down to Reports, reports.northwind, and select the Categories object, then hit Finish. We'll go to the field list, and you can see that all the fields are available. Let's drag category name onto the design surface for the report. And notice in this case, when we go to preview, there is no data available. And the reason why is because the categories object has no notion of how to pull data from the database. We'll fix that by using scripting. First thing, we'll go to the Solution Explorer and make sure that all of the assemblies are copied local. The reason we're going to do that is so the XPO assembly can be referenced by the script we're going to write now. Next, let's go to the Script References section and add a reference to the XPO assembly that we just copied locally and hit OK. Now we've got the scripts, and we can use the OnDataSourceDemanded event to generate the data for the report. The script has a couple of things that it needs to know about. Primarily, the report section, which is the actual assembly we've generated, link, because we're going to use a toList method, XPO, because that's where the session comes from, and the reports.northwind namespace to actually generate the categories objects. Finally, we set the default connection using the connection helper, and then we create the list of objects by creating a new session. We query the categories object and generate a list of them, and then we set it to the data source. Finally, we need to add the system.windows.forms assembly in order to use the binding source that we created earlier in the designer. And that's it. You can see that we can preview items directly from XPO. In this video, I showed you how to bind a report to an XPO-generated class that binds to the Northwind database. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.